Hello, javadhamidi here. In this video, we are going to ask a question that I get a lot, and that is how to array paths in Revit, or how to pass array in Revit. Many people, when they are using CAD and when they immigrate to Revit, they understand Revit doesn't have that tool. In Revit array tool, you just have the radial and linear tool. But that's not very hard. You can do it very easily with Dynamo. Okay, as you can see here, I have two model line. These are some splines because I want to make them a little bit, not straight lines and random, and make it a little bit harder. And you can create as many splines you want. And then you need to go to the Manage tab and click on Dynamo and open your Dynamo. You don't need to know anything about Dynamo, just follow the two things that I do. The first of all, you need to go to the Revit part, and in the Revit part, go to selection, and in selection you have a select element, select model element part, select the bring that in, click on it, and it will add the node that you need. Click on select and select the spline. We will do them one by one, not all of them. You can do that too, but I want more control on each line, so I'm going to make them like this. The next step is to bring this curve in your Dynamo environment. To do that, you need to go to the element part. Again, in element, in curve element, sorry. And indeed, you have this node which will obtain the curve geometry from the Revit element. Click on this one and click on it, and it will bring out the wire and connect this to this. As you can see, I've clicked on this and then this to see the, let me rotate a little bit. It is a little bit a big one, so we need to zoom out, and then we have the line. Okay, let's bring back to here. Then we have a Dynamo node which will give us point at parameter. Just search point at parameter, and then we will have the node. Connect your curve to this, and you need to create some parameters. To do that, you need to use a code block. To create a code block, just double click with your left mouse key, and then you will have the code block. Okay, the point at parameter is between 0 and 1, so we need to press 0 and then 1, and then we need the hashtag sign for number of elements or for number of families we want to place at this on this path. Then, for example, let me bring it on, let me give it a number, for example n, and let's create another, let's bring a slider in here to make it fully parametric. We want an integer slider, let me put it on, okay, 1 to 100, and connect this one to this, and then connect this one to this. Let me bring it off. For example, we will have, as you can see, when you increase this, it will create more divisions for this line. For example, let me put it on 20. That's great. Okay, let me clean this one a little bit. And then we have another family, which is you need to search for place and come down, and you have the place and instance. You can see this one will place an instance a model group, but let's scroll down. As you can see, this is the node that we need. Place a Revit family instance given at a specified point. Okay, bring it in and connect the points to this, and we need to specify the family type that we want to place in here. Right click in here and search for family type. The family that I want to place is a apple common plant. So let me click on it and let's go to NPC RPC section. These are the RPC ones, and let's bring the common apple. RPC 3 common apple, that's great. And then connect this one to this. As you can see, we have all of the trees that we want, and let's create let's make them parametric. As you can see, it is very easy to do this, and this is great, guys. And let's repeat this for the other one. Select all of them and press Ctrl C and Ctrl V, and let's change the base line. And then in here again, we can control the amount of families we want on second pass. That was it. I hope this video has been so helpful. Please don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends and colleagues. I will see you on the next session.